completely remember it. Okay, so that's that bit. Next, skin tone. And for skin tone, we're going to be going in with Screaming Skull. And we'll pop a little bit of that on our palette, into which some of the Bugman's Glow that we used for the main skin tone. I'm trying to get it around 50-50 mix. I don't want it too much of a difference from the main skin tone. There's two colours there that we can use, one slightly paler than the other. I may yet come back and add some more of the Screaming Skull, but we'll see how this goes first of all. And here we're just going to be adding this to some of the very raised areas. I think this still may be a little bit too pale. We'll see how it dries, because it does dry much paler than it actually goes on. So we'll see. What did I just say then? Did I say it dries pale? It doesn't dry pale, it darkens up a bit as it's drying. Oh dear lord. Getting myself completely confused in what I'm saying, but never mind. It's part of my charm, I do it all the time. And we'll just keep at it, popping the paint on where we can see that it's needed. Don't cover all the previous paints that we've just put on, because that won't look right at all. This is for the ultimate highlight, well, not ultimate highlight, this is for the very raised areas. If this doesn't dry as pale as I think it will, or as dark as I think it will, rather, I may need to come back a little bit later with a paler shade. But it's not looking too bad, I just need a little bit more water in it. There we go. And just making sure, as I say, all the raised areas are hit with this. Now, just touch up here. I'm sorry, I'm holding my breath because I don't want to knock myself, because this is quite detailed work around his face on the little creases and tucks. Yes, I'm making sure that all the areas that are raised gets touched with this colour. Try and make it as watery as you possibly can. It doesn't need to be a wash, but it does need to be quite dilute, just so it flows correctly. Oops. And make sure, as we say, that everywhere that is raised and not just raised but pointing to the light will get a little touch with this colour. This is what we're trying to do now. We're trying to get it so that we're showing where the light is hitting, not trying to build up the skin tone. There we go. I think that might be just right. That's that bit done. Next, we're going to go into what colour can we do? Okay, we're going to use a little bit of Avalon Sunset. Just a little bit, not much. Pop some of that on the palette. Into that, the Doomball Brown. Into that a little bit more of the Doomball Brown. There we are. And that will be the highlight colour for his little bag. We've not just mixed on that paint, however, just to do this little bit of work, we are going to mix another colour into that in a second to change it completely. Let's pop a little bit of the Abaddon Black in there, just to darken it down quite a bit, and then add some of the corn red. And this colour now is being used for the leather and the strap areas. And there we go. We'll just make sure that everywhere there's like a belt or some form of strap, we'll get a coating of this colour. And there's the main bit. Now there's this belt here around his waist. Now we'll just keep going back into it, until we've got everything that we need covered. I'm also going to do the banding around the sword in this colour as well. Just like so. Should really be the Warplot bronze. Come back to that in a moment. The thing is, when you're using or when you're painting a mini and you don't have it on a stand that you can move around, your fingers have a tendency of pulling off the paint in certain raised areas. It doesn't help matters, but if you're careful, you can minimise the problem. That's done. I'm going to do this around his neck. And oh, you may have noticed also I did that skull in the Warplot bronze as well. Okay, next I'm going to add more of the red into this, a little bit of that grey, I'm going to need a bit more of the corn red, I want to make a very different colour, is what I'm meaning to say. This is going to be for the sandals. And also use this as well for the straps holding onto the leg braces, for want of a better word. Not brace, it's a, I don't know what it is, shin guard or whatever. It may be called, but these little straps here, I'll use these. I'll use this colour for these as well. Until every word that we need doing is done. But as you know, my problem is that I always miss something. We'll see if I've done it with this. Fairly soon. It's not a great massive difference from the feet, but It is different enough. And that's all that matters. There we go, and now we're going to this one. Yeah, we'll do the strapping for his ankle armor. Happy with how that's looking now. What I want to do before we do anything more, as we did in the last one, using Avaland Sunset, quite a damp brush. Over the eyes to make it look divine energy radiating out from it. Hopefully it's working. And a brush now with a clean brush back over the eyes. I don't know whether I like that effect or not, to be honest. I hope. Right, going back in with the Screaming Skull. Onto the skin tone. Some lighter shades here and there along the skin tone. And this should then signal almost the end for this mini. There's a couple of little bits and pieces I need to do before we go any further with him. Well, before, so not before we go any further, but before finish. And that is, I need to highlight the metal areas. And to highlight the metal areas, we're going in with Stormhold Silver that you saw earlier, and our dry brush, which you also saw earlier. And just give it a little shake to make sure. And all I want to do is just brush on around the top. Pick out some of the raised areas. We're not looking at covering every single part. We're just looking at picking out the detail, and not just picking up the detail but also highlighting and making sure that it looks nice and shiny. And that, I think, is it. For Hades. Just make sure that there is another bit of metallic area that I need to do, which I've just remembered about. So better get this done. Don't brush. Into the Stormhold Silver. And yeah, it's just these little bracelet things. There we are. There's one. Oh, it's all wearing one. Now just make sure the buckles on these belts are done as well. That is it now for Hades. So let us know. It's not quite, I think there's some one more thing I can do with Hades before we can call it quits. And using Pallid Witch Flesh. Just going to add a touch of white. Also, at the top and bottom of the mouth, we'll put a bit of this white. To give it, make it look as though there's teeth in there. And I've just noticed I've pulled off some of the core here. So let's go back in with that red we used with the sandals. And just for the sake of devilment, a little bit of the Doomble Brown. And we'll just dry brush downwards on the scabbard of his sword. And using some of the I've just realised I've not finished off the clothing. Evil Scarlets this time. We haven't finished as yet. We still have more to do. So, Evil Some Scarlets. And we're just going to use this. Some of the higher of the raised areas. The very edges of these raised folds. And around the edges of the holes as well. Just make a point of doing this. Make sure when you do this you don't go everywhere. And so this is the final highlights for the clothing. You just want this to be in the raised areas, the very edges of clothing, that kind of the very edges of the holes. This is the bit that actually takes quite a bit of time to do, because you want to make sure that you get it in certain places and take time picking out those places. We don't want to do it anywhere where it's in shade. And you certainly don't want to do a great amount of this either, so that you cover up any of the previous red. So just take your time, watch what you're doing with it. that is Hades. All done. Hope you enjoy this. Until next time, as always, if I could do as well, using a little bit of this. Slightly dry brush on the spear. Don't want it too strong. And you also don't want it going right to the very edges. That won't do. There we are. So that's Hades. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Until next time, as always, take care, God bless, and bye for now. Don't forget to let us know which one you'd like to see next. Ares or Zeus.